Hey everyone, I'm Varun Vadvani and welcome to yet another video. Today I'm going to discuss with you all a very common and yet interesting problem, that is crossing river problem, through which we will understand the common operating systems concepts that are deadlock and starvation. First of all, what does the problem say? The problem statement is like this. A river to be crossed has number of stepping stones. It is assumed that at most 1 foot can be on each stepping stone at a time, and to cross the river, a person must use each of the stepping stones. Before moving on to the problem, let us first understand the terms deadlock and starvation with respect to operating system. Now, what is deadlock? In a set of processes, two or more processes are said to be in a deadlock state when one process waits for one or more waiting processes to cause a particular event. Here, event means resource acquisition and resource release. Let us understand it with an example. As you can see, there are two processes P0 and P1 and two resources A and B. P0 has currently acquired the resource A and P1 has currently acquired the resource B. Now, P0 wants to acquire resource B but hasn't released resource A, and P1 wants to acquire resource A but hasn't released resource B. So, in this situation, P0 waits for P1 to release B, and similarly, P1 waits for P0 to release A. Both processes are in waiting state and none of them will be able to acquire the resource and therefore can't be executed further. Hence, we will say that process P0 and process P1 are in a deadlock state. Now, what is starvation? When a process waits to acquire one or more resources for a long time and is unable to do that as those resources are acquired by other processes, then we say that process is going through starvation. Let me simplify this with an example. Here we can see there are two processes P0 and P1 and a resource A. P0 is acquiring the resource A and P1 is waiting to acquire the same resource, that is A. If P0 is not releasing the resource A and P1 waits too long for it, we say that P1 is experiencing starvation. It can be viewed as each person crossing the river as a process and each stepping stone as a resource. Stepping on a stone can be viewed as acquiring a resource, while removing food from the resource can be viewed as releasing it. When two or more people try to step on the same stone, that situation is known as deadlock. The deadlock can be resolved if either person move away to the side of the river from where they started. In operating system terms, this move back is referred as rollback. While crossing the river, deadlock can occur during one of the two situations. First, when several people tries to cross the river from the same side at the same time. And second, when a person crosses the river from one side without knowing that someone is crossing the river from the other side too. The only way to ensure that the deadlock will not occur is that each person crossing the river should follow an agreed upon protocol. This means that each person before crossing the river should find out whether someone else is crossing the river from the other side or not. If someone is not crossing, then that person should proceed, else he should wait until the other person has finished crossing. Thus, a mechanism must exist to determine someone is crossing the river, and this will only be possible if we know the state of every stepping stone. But if the river is too wide or the other end is not visible, this mechanism will fail. Therefore, some other mechanism should exist. Here, we can see that two people are crossing the river from the opposite sides. Hence, deadlock will definitely occur. If each waits for the other to start, then indefinite waiting will occur, that is starvation, which is clearly visible. So something should be done so that without deadlock and starvation, people from both the sides can cross the river. One way of doing that is assigning higher priority to one of the sides or banks of the river. Say we assign higher priority to east bank. So people on the higher priority bank will start crossing the river first, while people on the west bank will wait. If this protocol is applied, problem of deadlock will definitely get solved, but there is a possibility that people on the low priority bank waits for a long time and hence will undergo starvation, which we can see in the picture too. Therefore, this protocol must be extended. One way of doing this is gradually increasing the priority of people waiting for a long time on the low priority bank. This technique is known as aging. By doing this, people initially on higher priority bank will not monopolize, and hence people on both the sides will equally get chance to cross the river. So this was a solution to the crossing river problem without any deadlock or starvation. Thank you for watching. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. It gives me encouragement to make more videos. Feel free to tell me if you want video lectures on any topic related to operating systems or computer architecture. I'll be happy to help you. Bye-bye.